to Sunday School. Since Easter, we've been talking about relationships, and we began with Christ's death on the cross. This was the beginning of our relationship with God. Last week, we focused on friendships, which is another type of relationship that we have with our friends. Today, we're going to look at the very first relationship that you and I have ever had. It's our relationship with our mothers. Today, we celebrate Mother's Day. It's a day to let our moms know how much we love them and how much we appreciate and thank them for all that they do for us to make our lives complete. Before we were even born, our mothers cared for us by taking care of themselves, by eating right, by taking their vitamins, and making sure that no harm came to us. Today, they continue that by caring for us, protecting us, and guiding us so that we can have a fruitful life, the type of life that God wanted us to have. I do want to share with you, though, that there are some mothers who aren't able to care for their children for whatever reason. This is when a very special person steps into their lives. It could be their grandmother, a nana, an aunt, or a friend. And they give them the love, the care, the safety, and the guidance that a child needs. And this is like having two mothers, a mother who gave us life and a mother who gives us a life. This is a very special mom who deserves some very special praise on a day like today. So I have a secret for you. You know what? Being a mom doesn't come with any instructions. No instruction manuals. Each of us moms does our very best to raise you and to love you. Many times it's based on what we've learned from our own mothers. In the Bible, though, God gives us some guidance. The book of Deuteronomy tells us this: "And these words that I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise." So God gives us as mothers good guidance. So bringing you to Sunday School each week, and then continuing those teachings at home during the week, guides us as moms and helps us to raise you to be children of God. As you grow older, though, God expects you to remember the many hours that your parents spent guiding you and teaching you. On a day like today, it's a day that we're supposed to appreciate that. Listen to these verses in Proverbs. "Listen, my son, to your father's instruction, and do not forsake your mother's teaching. They are a garland to grace your head and a chain to adorn your neck. Train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from that." I especially like the part in the verse where it says, "a garland to grace your head and a chain to adorn your neck." So you see, our parents' wisdom in their teachings and in their instructions are like pretty jewelry, something that brings a special quality into our lives, something that we admire, and also things that other people admire in us. The love that mothers have for their children is unconditional. It's the same type of love that God has for us. So what does that mean? Well, it's a love that has no limits and it has no conditions. A mother's love goes on forever and ever. It has no end. A mother's love is always with us. It never, ever leaves us. It has no conditions. For example, your mom, her love for you doesn't depend on you cleaning your room, and it doesn't depend on you making wise choices. She loves you no matter what. The Bible tells us in 1 Corinthians about love. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love never fails. Well, there are many mothers that are mentioned in the Bible. They loved their children just like your mother loves you. Here are just a few. So let me see what you remember. Who was the first mother ever mentioned in the Bible? Did you guess Eve? She was the mother of Cain and Abel. How about the most famous mother in the Bible? Who was Jesus' mother? Well, I hope you remembered it was Mary. Do you remember the woman in the Bible who became a mother when she was very old? She waited all of her life for God to give her a child. Do you remember Sarah? She was the mother of Isaac. Okay, one last one. This one's kind of difficult. Do you remember the mother of John the Baptist? She was also the cousin of Jesus' mother, Mary. Did you guess? It was Elizabeth. So I want to encourage you to celebrate your mom every day. She gave you life, and she continues each day to make sure that you're happy, you're safe, you're loved, and you're cared for. She's devoted her entire life to you. And I can promise you this, you are the very first person she thinks of every morning when she wakes up. So honor her every day. So let's close in prayer. Bow your heads, please. Dear God, we love you. You love us, and you care for us in all of our needs. We give you thanks for our mothers and for all of the women you have placed in our lives to love and